Yes, good evening, dear students. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. How are you all? Yes, Swan Kumari, Priyanshu, Ajay, Manish, Harsha, Zion, Shiv Prasad, Ajesh. A very good evening to all of you. A very good evening to all of you. Yes. So, this is Rakesh Talreja and I welcome you to the India's largest live learning platform, that is GradeUp, and to your favorite GradeUp Gate YouTube channel. Your favorite great YouTube channel, that is the GradeUp Gate YouTube channel, right? Yes, Sai Kishore, Prabhavati, Vashishta, Prakhar, Sri Ram, good evening all of you. I hope you are all safe at home, enjoying your studies, lockdown studies, focus on your studies, right? Yes, so as I told you, we are going to break the root locus into three parts. Take care, root locus into three parts, and that is today is the class number two, root locus class number two today. And as I have discussed with you, that today in the class number two, okay, yeah, I'm fine. Ramprasad plus Chisek, video is there. I'm all fine, little down with the health right now. Yeah, but we'll try to continue with the session. Yes, Shiv Shankar, good evening. So as you know, this session is about the angle of departure, and the angle of arrival. Okay. Yeah, Ramprasad, fine, I've identified you now. Yes. Okay, so I think please refresh your page. Video should be there. I'm viewing the session parallelly. Yes, the video is there with me. Yes. So root locus 2, as I told, is for the angle of departure and arrival. The important calculation of angle of departure and arrival. And let's proceed with the class. This is, as always, brief introduction about me. As you already know, I'm Rakesh Talreja, and I've secured All India rank 9th in the GATE examination. And I have completed my master's from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. And it's been more than 10 years of me taking the classes for GATE and ESE. Okay, yes, Joy and Banerjee, good evening. Okay, yes, Ajesh and Sai Kishore, thanks for the concern. Yeah. Shravani, the objective type class will be tomorrow. Today I'm going to explain the concept of angle of departure and angle of arrival. Okay, and these are my major area of expertise. Okay, and several free classes are running on the GradeUp app, that is engineering service main classes, and the concept on fingertip classes like by Ashutosh Saxena sir, Vijay Bansal sir. Okay, and let's get started. I was also having some CFT classes that I finished today about the electromagnetic theory. Yes, to sketch the root locus of the system having the open loop transfer function given to you. Okay, so as you know, this class is mostly about angle of departure and arrival. So I will start with that calculation, and then obviously we will sketch the root locus. Okay, so angle of departure and arrival will come for complex poles and zeros. Okay, if you have complex poles, whenever you have complex poles, you need to calculate their angle of departure. Okay, angle of departure. No, Vashishta, obviously questions are there, and for all variety of MCQ, you can come tomorrow. Tomorrow is the root locus class number 3. There I am going to discuss all variety of MCQ question. Okay, all important conceptual tricky questions that are a part of GATE and engineering services, I am going to discuss that tomorrow. Okay, but before, if you are comfortable in all the questions, I want to discuss about the complex poles and zeros. Okay, and whenever open loop transfer function has complex zeros, you will be determining the angle of arrival. Okay, so I'm going to explain the calculation of angle of departure and angle of arrival. Okay. Yeah, Shravani, sometimes I've observed that students do mistake. That is why I'm taking it as a separate topic. And this is not only important for sketching the root locus, dear students. But there have been several times question in GATE 2 marker. Mostly this will be expected as 2 marker. Individual question on given GSHS, just determine the angle of departure or the angle of arrival. So it is also a very important individual question that you must remember. It is a very important individual question also. Okay. So sketch the root locus of the system having the open loop transfer function. So what is GSHS? Equal to K is divided by is divided by s, s plus 4, s square plus 4s plus 20. Okay, s square plus 4s plus 20. Yeah, Prabhavati, for negative values of k, it is known as the complementary root locus, and I will take up with the MCQ question. Okay, there the rules for angle of departure arrival will change. Right now, I am taking positive value of k. Okay, right now, positive value of k. Okay, so k, first of all, let us write down the open loop pole. See, open loop zeros are available? No, there are no open loop zeros available. Okay. So let us take the open loop poles of this function. Open loop poles means s is equal to 0. Minus 4, 0, minus 4, and other will be solved by the quadratic equation. So let us solve the quadratic equation. Minus b plus minus root over b square, that is 16, minus 4ac, so that becomes minus 80 divided by 2 into a. Okay, so this is equal to 0 minus 4, and minus 4 plus minus under root of minus 64, under root of minus will be j, and under root of 64 will be 8, is divided by 2. So ultimately you have 0 minus 4 and divide by 2, so minus 2 plus minus j4, minus 2 plus minus j4, right? Minus 2 plus minus j4. Minus 2 plus minus j4. Correct everyone? Now, that means you have minus 2 plus minus j4, that is pair of complex poles. And with respect to the pair of complex poles, as I have told you, you need to calculate the angle of departure. You need to calculate the angle of departure. I am focusing first on angle of departure, then obviously plots will come up. So, what is the angle of departure? It is actually given by the formula 180 degree minus 5p minus 5z. Okay, 180 degree minus 5p minus 5z. Okay, if it is the case of, if k is negative, that is basically, I told you yesterday, if k is negative, that is basically known as the complementary root locus. Okay, and if k is negative, then the angle of departure is given by the formula minus of 5p minus 5z. Minus of 5p minus 5z. Now, what is 5p and 5z? I will explain you that. Okay. You know, as Shravani, you were telling, and I've observed other students also, why the calculation mistakes, why the mistake occurs, because, you know, mostly there is simple analytical formula also, but when you take it analytically, you know, the chances of mistakes and confusion arises. So I'm going to show it geometrically, what is the angle of departure. And if you solve with geometry, it is going to be a peaceful, correct process. Accuracy will be maintained. Okay. So what is 5P and 5Z? Let me explain this to you by sketching the geometry. Okay. What geometry? Just sketch the pole zero diagram of this transfer function. Just listen everyone. Sketch the pole zero diagram of this transfer function. Just sketch the pole zero diagram of this transfer function. So there are no zeros, obviously we know that. There are no zeros, but there are poles. What are the poles? Let us just highlight the poles. What are the poles of this transfer function? 0, all the poles, whether it is real pole or complex pole. 0, minus 4, minus 2 plus minus j4. So one of the pole is at origin. Let's say minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. And minus 2 plus minus, just a second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Accordingly, I will take the subdivisions here also, according to what I have taken on the y-axis. This is minus 1, it's minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. Okay. Just I'm trying to sketch the poles. This is J4. No, Harsha, for this question, calculation of nothing is done till now. I'm just starting with the angle of departure first of all. directly started with angle of departure for this question. Rest about centroid and asymptotes, breakaway, that we have learned yesterday. Same thing we will apply what we have learned yesterday. Okay. So this is a pole minus 2 minus J4 and this is a pole minus 2 plus J4. Okay. And I am focusing on the angle of departure. Okay. Because it is the first time I am explaining it very peacefully to you. Just explaining it peacefully to you. Now, once you understand, then it should be a quick method. So what you are going to do, suppose you are going to find angle of departure for the pole minus 2 plus J4. Pick up any one of them first. Okay. And what you will do, join this pole with respect to all the other poles and zeros. Join this pole with respect to all the other poles and zeros, right? Join this pole with respect to all the other poles and zeros. Okay, all the other poles and zeros, right? Yes. Now, the line of joining, make the direction of the line of joining towards that pole whose angle of departure is being calculated, towards that pole. Okay. And let us calculate the angle of all the poles and zeros. As I've told you, this formula involves phi p and phi z. Okay. What is phi p and phi z? Listen, everyone. Phi p is basically sum of all the angles subtended by remaining poles. Sum of all the angles subtended by the remaining poles. Okay. So there will be a phi p value. And then what is the meaning of phi z? Phi z means sum of all the angles. Yeah, to calculate the angle, Shiv Shankar, to calculate the angle. What angle am I just explaining? Sum of all the angles subtended by zeros. Okay. Subtended by zero. Now, what is phi p here? Phi p, sum of all the angles subtended by the remaining poles. So, you know, you have one of this pole. Let's say this angle is phi p1, sum of angle subtended with the first pole. Let's say this is phi p2, the angle subtended with the other pole. And this is phi p3. Phi p3, angle subtended with the third pole. Okay, third pole, right? So, what is the value of phi p1? What is the value of phi p1? Yes. What is the value of phi p1? The phi p will be actually equal to the sum of all these angles, phi p1 plus phi p2 plus phi p3. And where, what is phi p1? So I'll write down the value of phi p1 for you. Phi p1 can be calculated by 180 minus this angle alpha. 180 minus alpha, right? So what is phi p1? It is 180 degree minus alpha, and that alpha is tan inverse height by base. Now look at the height. Height of this triangle, if you take alpha, height of the triangle is 4 and base of the triangle is 2. Height is 4 and base is 2. The 180 minus internal angle. So tan inverse 4 by 2. Need not calculate tan inverse 4 by 2 right now. It is 180 degree minus tan inverse 2. Okay. Then what is phi p2? What is phi p2? Now see, phi p2, the second pole makes a vertical line because of the complex conjugate pole. They are on the vertical line. So what is the value of phi p2? It is just 90 degree. It is from the observation. It is a vertical line. So it is perpendicular to the x-axis. Okay. And then next calculate phi p3. And what is phi p3? That is the interior angle only. This is phi p3. The interior angle. And that is just tan inverse height by base. Now that is just tan inverse height upon base 4 by 2, and that is equal to tan inverse 2. That is why I told, need not calculate the tan inverse 2, because when you add them, it is going to be cancelled out. So what is the total value of phi p? Phi p1 plus 5p2 plus 5p3, right? And that is equal to 180 minus tan inverse 2 plus 90 plus tan inverse 2. Okay, minus and plus cancelled. 180 plus 90 is equal to what? It is equal to 270 degree. So what is the 5p coming to me, guys? It is 270 degree. 270 degree, right? Now, dear students, listen to this important point. Yeah, listen to this important point. This 5p is okay. Let me complete the 5d first. What is 5d? It is given by 180 degree minus 5p minus 5z. And that is equal to 180 degree minus 5p, that is 270, 5z, that is equal to 0. Net angle is minus 90 degree. Net angle is minus 90 degree. Clear, everyone? The net angle is equal to minus 90 degree. Okay, angle of departure. Now, dear students, why I am telling you this method? Listen to the important point. Okay, as you know, as Vasishta was specifying, and yeah, even there are in the books formula to solve the angle, but I don't suggest the formula. And yeah, it is not being completely written, correctly written by Vasishta, please recheck. Why I'm not suggesting formula, because anyways, guys, if you are starting the root locus now, when you are going to sketch the root locus, so in the root locus plot, in the root locus plot, obviously you are going to sketch the poles and zeros, right? Obviously in the root locus plot, you are going to sketch the poles and zeros. And how much of the time you need to identify? See, listen very carefully. 5p2 is just 90. It is the vertical line. No confusion. How much time you need to write down the angle 5p3 and 5p1? It is tan inverse height by base. Now, if you go by the formula also, now, if you directly go by the formula, so you may get the cases of tan inverse y upon minus x or tan inverse minus y by minus x. And if you don't take care of the quadrant, your answers will be wrong. I know many students commit the mistake in the quadrant. Okay, many students commit mistakes in the quadrant. So that is why, how much time you need to calculate 5p3 and 5p1? How much time you need to calculate 5p1 and 5p3? It's almost within seconds. It is almost within seconds. Okay, so let us take the answer and proceed forward first of all, and then I will put my concluding remarks. So 5d is just equal to minus 90. 5d is just equal to minus 90. I'll repeat for your explanation. I have taken some time to explain you, but actually if you look into the geometry, it is nothing. It is just nothing, absolutely, right? Okay, it is a matter of seconds. Tan inverse height by base is only you have to do. And obviously a pole will have the conjugate pole. Every pole will have the conjugate pole. And when you join the pole with the conjugate pole, it is going to be a vertical line. And because it is a vertical line, the angle will be 90 degrees. So only the other angle you have to calculate. Okay. Yes, Harsha, 5P3 same tan inverse height. See, what is the height of this triangle? I'll just show you by the pointer. Look at this height. Height is 4, base is 2. The height is 4 and the base is 2. Okay, so tan inverse 4. This is height. Look at this J4. And the base, minus 2 say minus 4, the base is 2. The tan inverse height by base, internal angle of the triangle it is. Na? So you can apply the trigonometry. So it's a very simple trigonometry. Is that clear, Harsha? 5P3? So my angle of departure is minus 90 here. Now what does that angle of departure says? I'm just going to continue the question further so that you are able to understand the angle of departure in the question also, right? Yes. This is angle of departure now, right? Now, dear students, let us talk about the asymptotes. Some calculations now. Let us talk about the asymptotes. Okay. Now, asymptotes. How many asymptotes you need, guys? It is given by the formula P minus Z. Okay, that is equal to 3. Okay. No, Harsha, you will apply the trigonometry on the right angle triangle. Now, if you consider the base 4, that is not right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Yeah, Ramu, that's what I'm telling you. This is going to take less time than the formula. Okay. Formula, I am sure my experience is there. Formula, students take time and it is committing mistake also. That is why I'm focusing on the simple geometry. I know, Ramu, you might have seen before also because you have qualified the gate this year. So this will take simple time. n equal to p minus z, and now theta 2k plus 1 divided by 3 into 180 degree, where k is 0, 1 and 2. Achha, you can just remember, not necessary to solve every time. Okay, 2k plus 1 divided by 4, n minus z is 4 here. Okay. N minus z is p minus z is 4. There are 4 poles and no zeros. Okay, actually there are 4 poles and no zeros. So 2k plus 1 divided by 4 into 180 degree, and that theta will be equal to 45 degree, 135 degree, 225 degree and 315 degree, right? Okay, and then the centroid, x is equal to summation of poles, and I'm just calculating the centroid. We know the formula for the centroid. Summation of poles, the summation of poles, the pole is 0, then pole is minus 4, minus 2 plus j4, minus 2, minus j4, minus zeros divided by 4. Divided by 4. So it turns out to be how much if you are able to see? Minus 8 by 4. The centroid is minus 2. So these are the asymptotic calculation terms. Okay. Now next what you need to do is, breakaway points. Next what you need to do is check the breakaway point. Okay. Breakaway point ke liye you need the characteristic equation. Guys, I shall give you 2 minutes of time. I have explained you breakaway point. Breakaway point. Yes. Can you calculate the breakaway points here? Breakaway points ke liye you need to solve what? Find the value of, I've explained the procedure yesterday. Find the value of k. Yes, Swarnakumar, it is minus 8 divided by 4. So the centroid is minus 2 finally. Okay. Summation p minus summation z divided by p minus z. Okay. Yes, what Sai Kumar, what 3 has been missing? It's everything fine, I think. Yes. The centroid is minus 2. And dear student, just listen, find k from the characteristic equation and then solve dk by ds equal to 0. I give you a 2 minute time right now because this calculation has been explained by me to you yesterday. It has been explained to you yesterday. So please take a 2 minutes of time and let us solve. Okay, I give you a 2 minutes of time. Yes. Yes, dear students, just went to take up a medicine and all. I'm not feeling well today. I went away to take a medicine only. Okay, so let us now continue the class. I hope you have solved the breakaway points. Theek hai, you have solved the breakaway points. Yes, Ramu, what you're writing is the value of the poles, na? So let us write down the breakaway points. Yes, focus everyone. Focus everyone. So what is the characteristic equation first of all? That is 1 plus k divided by s. What is the characteristic equation? What is the GSHS? Take that directly. S plus 4 s square plus 4s plus 20 equal to 0. Okay. So from here directly you are able to see that k is minus s s plus 4 s square plus 4s plus 20, right? Yeah guys, sorry for a small interruption. I've just gone to take a small medicine so that I get some energy. Minus s square plus 4s into s square plus 4s plus 20, and this is equal to minus of s square plus 4s s power 4 plus 16 s square a square plus b square plus 2ab, that is 8s plus 20 s square plus 24 ats. Okay, correct. S power 4 plus 16 s square plus 2ab, 8s cube, sorry, 8s cube plus 20 s square plus 24 ats. So k is eventually minus of, if I simplify the term, s power 4, 8s cube, 20 and 16, 36 s square plus 80s. Solve dk by ds equal to 0. Now I am calculating dk by ds equal to 0 in this question in detail for a very special reason. To understand that, this is equal to minus of 4s cube plus 24 s square plus 24 s square plus 36 into 2 72 s plus 80 equal to 0, right? And taking just 4 common, so you get s cube plus 6 s square, theek hai, plus 6 s square divided by 4, this becomes 18 s plus 20 equal to 0, theek hai. Yeah, I hope I'll just get well soon. Maybe not feeling, because it has been so many classes since these days. But yeah, I'm fine. I'm at least you are able to understand my thing. That is my assurance. Okay. Anywhere, if you get that, please let me know. Okay. It's just a part. This is important. That is why I don't want to miss anything of that. Okay. So now taking 4 common, I'd get this. Now listen, everyone. Listen, everyone. Obviously, in the current date, if I talk about the gate. If I talk about the gate, the scientific calculators for cubic, it is not allowed. But I am taking still the cubic equation for a special reason. I have told you something special yesterday that is going to come here. So let us solve this cubic equation. Let me give you the roots by the calculator itself. That should be fine. Yes. So I am getting s is equal to minus 2. One of them is minus 2, and other two are complex. And it is given by minus 2 plus j 2.4. J2.45 or J2.4 approximately. J2.4 plus minus J2.4. Right. Now, I was trying to tell you something yesterday that there may be the possibility of complex conjugate poles. There may be the possibility of complex conjugate poles. Complex conjugate breakaway point. Whether it is true or not, whether it is true or not, that I am going to tell you right now. Okay. So s equal to minus 2, this is real. Whether it is a valid breakaway point or not, this we will see once I start sketching the graph. But what about this one? What about this one? Minus 2 plus minus j2.4. Minus 2 plus minus j2.4. What about this one? Okay. So let us check that. Let us check that. Valid or not. So I've told you one thing yesterday. Breakaway point is ultimately lying on the root locus only, and any point lying on the root locus. See, listen everyone, listen very carefully. Once I start sketching,
ठीक है, वंस आई स्टार्ट स्केचिंग द रूट लोकस, देयर ऑल्सो यू विल अंडरस्टैंड कि यस इट इज अ वैलिड ब्रेकअवे पॉइंट, बट आई एम टेलिंग यू द कॉन्सेप्ट फर्स्ट, एंड फर्स्ट लेट मी टेक द कॉन्सेप्ट, एंड फॉर ऑल द वेराइटी ऑफ क्वेश्चन टुमारो आई हैव केप्ट द क्लास फॉर ऑल वेराइटी ऑफ क्वेश्चन, एंड वेन आई गो टू द एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन, ना ठीक है, वेन आई गो टू द एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन डेफिनेटली विल बी टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट द शॉर्टकट मेथड्स. तो एनी पॉइंट लाइंग ऑन द रूट लोकस विल सैटिस्फाई टू थिंग्स दैट आई हैव बीन टेलिंग यू यस्टरडे. ठीक है, दैट आई हैव बीन टेलिंग यू यस्टरडे, दैट इज मॉड GSHS इक्वल टू वन, एंगल GSHS इज इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस 180 डिग्री. अरे डियर स्टूडेंट्स, डियर वामशी एंड ऑल, डोंट वरी अबाउट, सी आई हैव टोल्ड यू द करेंट पैटर्न ऑफ गेट, इफ इट इज, you know, if it is, you know, we can divide by s by 2, Zion, absolutely correct, but need not worry if you are focusing with the MCQ question, na, such a equation will not come in front of you. Listen to my feelings, such a question will not come to you in the MCQ form. But why I am taking to you right now, because yesterday you were asking na, ki complex breakaway ho sakta hai ki nahi. Yes, complex breakaway is true, and to make you explain that I have taken this case. Okay, so do not worry about cubic calculation, worry about the concept right now. एंगल जी एस एच एस इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस 180 डिग्री, ठीक है, एस प्लस टू से डिवाइड करके तो आ जाएगा, दैट इज ओके, प्लस माइनस 180 डिग्री. तो यूज दिस नाउ. ओके, जी एस एच एस इज इक्वल टू के डिवाइडेड बाय एस एस प्लस 4 एस स्क्वायर प्लस 4 एस प्लस 20. ओके, सो put down s is equal to minus 2 plus j 2.4, the point which you are trying to check. Okay, so what is GSHS? That is equal to k divided by s minus 2 plus j 2.4. okay, look at the calculation, just and s plus 4, if you add 4, so this minus 2 plus 4 becomes plus 2, so 2 plus j 2.4, right, and s square plus 4 s plus 20, what will be s square? Minus 2 plus j 2.4 whole square plus 4s plus 20. Okay, let us solve this carefully. Okay, so just follow the calculations with me. The first two terms is x plus jy, x minus jy form. So this is going to be k divided by minus 2.4 square minus 4, the solution of the first two term, j 2.4 minus 2 and j 2.4 plus 2, a plus b and a minus b, so that is a square minus b square, right, j square is minus 1. Now what about the next term? Let us open the a plus b whole square, so that is 4 minus, see, let me directly tell you what is 2.4 whole square, it is going to be 5.76, so better I will replace with the values, minus 5.76. okay, and then 4 a square plus b square will be j 2.4 whole square, so again minus 5.76. okay, and minus 2ab, minus 2ab will make it minus j 9.6, 2.4 into 4, okay, minus 8 plus j 2.4 into 4, so j 9.6 plus 20. The point to be noted here is J 9.6 and minus J 9.6 have been cancelled out. And because of this cancellation, what is the GSHS left? Okay. So dear student, this calculation is not with respect to MCQ, but this calculation is for an important concept. So those who want concept, please just follow with patience. Minus 5.76 minus 4, minus 9.76. Multiplied by, see what is coming here, 4 minus 5.76 and 20 minus 8 is 4, 20 minus 8 becomes 12, 12 plus 4, 16, 16 minus 5.76, so it is 16 minus 5.76, that is nothing but 10.24. ultimately it is, overall, if you take, k is also a real number. So now listen, everyone. Overall, if you take, it is a negative real value. GSHS is a negative real value. And because it's a negative real value, what is angle GS? What do you know about the angle of a negative real value? See, angle is always measured with respect to the x-axis, na? angle is always measured with respect to the x-axis. So there is a point lying on the negative x-axis, and when you measure the angle, when you measure the angle from the positive x-axis, obviously that angle is 180 degree, na? So angle GSHS is equal to 180 degree, plus or minus. If you take clockwise, it becomes the minus angle. And hence S is equal to minus 2 plus J 2.4. Root locus is symmetric. If there is a X plus JY point, obviously conjugate will be there. So minus 2 plus minus J 2.4 are valid complex breakaway points. They are the valid complex breakaway points. Right? Understood everyone now? Now, they are valid complex breakaway point. And now, my dear students, just follow the graph with me. Just follow the root locus graph with me. Yes. So everyone now just follow the final root locus graph for this function. Let us first take the poles and zeros as always. The pole is at 0. This is the pole minus 4, right? Then, first of all, before sketching any branches, let me complete all the poles. Yes, this is another pole. This is another pole, minus 2 plus J4. And this one will be another one, complex conjugate pole, minus 2 minus J4. Now, listen everyone, that first, before sketching the branches, as always, as I was doing yesterday, first let us place the asymptotes. Okay, asymptotes are taken by the green color. So minus 2 is the centroid. Asymptotic calculation we have seen, na? Asymptotic calculation, centroid is minus 2, and there are 4 asymptotes at 45, 135, 225 and 315 degree. Let me take that. Asymptote is at minus 2. Okay, so angle, first angle is 45 degree. Because the first angle is 45 degree, it should pass through J2. Tan inverse height by base should match. And then just have a free sketching. Okay, so this one will be the fourth one. It should pass with the minus J2 and then extend them vertically backwards. So this is your third asymptote. And this one approximately should be passing through this, and this one approximately is going to be your fourth asymptote. These are the four asymptotes in picture, right? Four asymptotes of the picture. Now this is the centroid minus 2 color. Now after sketching the asymptote, let us start with the root locus branches. Okay, root locus branches. Okay, so everyone, now we know that the root locus branches will start from the open loop poles. Now, odd property. You remember everyone, odd number property? Odd number criteria of the existence of the root locus on the real axis, I have explained you yesterday. Root locus, will the root locus exist here? So see, if you count from here towards the right, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is total 4 and even number. So here the root locus should not exist. Okay. And then, if you take it in this part, Yes, I hope everyone is following with the concentration. And if I take it into this part, how many poles are seen towards the right? 1, 2, 3. And even if you pull, the complex conjugate poles are not going to matter much because they always come in pair. If you see here also, it is 1. That is also odd. This is also odd. Right? Right? So, root locus will exist where? According to the odd number criteria. According to the odd number criteria, root locus will exist on the real axis between minus 4 and origin. Between the minus 4 and origin. Even if you see towards, even if you see after the origin, if you see this section, how many poles and zeros? Nil. That is counted in even. Okay, so root locus will not exist here also. The root locus will only exist between minus 4 and 0. So from the minus 4, the root locus will start towards the right. And from the origin, it will start towards the left. Will start towards the left. Okay. From the origin, it is starting towards the left. From the minus 4, starting towards the right because of the existence. So what is the, again, the picture that you are seeing? That two branches traveling in opposite direction. And if two branches traveling in opposite direction, they must intersect. Intersection happens where? Intersection happens at the breakaway point. So see, where is the breakaway point? See, one of this breakaway point, minus 2, is now valid. I've told you now, I will say whether it is valid or invalid. Like I was telling yesterday, whether it is valid or invalid, it will be told by what? It will be told once you start sketching. Yes, minus 2 is on the real axis existence part. And you're clearly able to see that, yes, branches traveling in opposite direction. So make them come and intersect at this point. Okay. So what has happened here? Two branches have intersected. Okay. Two branches have intersected. Now, further picture. Where are the other branches? Actually, how many branches should be here? Actually, four branches, because branches starts from where? One branch starts from every open loop pole. One branch will start from every open loop pole. So one pole, one branch will start. One pole, one branch will start. So here also the branch should start. Na? How do the branches start from the complex pole? That is what I have calculated the angle of departure, students. What is the angle of departure? Minus 90. And see, listen everyone. This was the angle of departure for the pole minus 2 plus J4, that is minus 90. Now, another pole, you don't need to calculate the angle of departure. For another pole, you don't need to calculate the angle of departure. It is always opposite in sign, minus of minus 90 degree, and that is plus 90 degree. For the complex conjugate pole, never calculate the angle of departure. They are always going to be opposite sign, but same value. Okay, same value. Okay. Okay. Yeah, Shiv Prasad, it does not matter whether the open loop pole is even or odd. Okay. Existence property says that the total number of poles and zeros towards the right, quantity of the poles and zeros towards the right should be an odd number. Quantity. Okay. If you have followed the yesterday's class, quantity of the poles and zeros towards the right of any section should be an odd number. Okay, not the value of pole and zero ki baat nahi kar raha, quantity of poles and zeros ki baat kar raha hai. Okay. Shiv Prasad, think about the quantity of poles and zeros, right? So, what is the angle of departure here? Minus 90. As the word says, departure. Angle of departure, matlab at what angle the root locus branch will depart from this pole. Will depart from this pole. So, let me start a root locus branch. Departing angle is minus 90. Now, dear students, everyone knows that. Just listen, everyone. Everyone knows that we calculate the angle with respect to what? We calculate the angle with respect to the positive x-axis always. And that angle I want as minus 90 degree. I want the angle as minus 90 degree. How can you obtain that angle as minus 90? Minus, with respect to angle, minus is always what? Minus is clockwise. Minus is clockwise. Okay. And 90 means vertical. 90 means perpendicular. So go perpendicular clockwise. Okay. Clockwise matlab is sense. That is why direction is important. If it was plus 90, then it would be this sense. Okay. So what is that 90 degree angle line? I'll just sketch that 90 degree angle line for you. This angle is minus 90. Why minus 90? Because it is clockwise. Okay. So now from this pole, I have to start a branch traveling along the minus 90 degree line. So see. And similarly, because of symmetry. Here also, if you want, I can show you the angle. Here also, if you want, I'll show you the angle. Angle taken with respect to x-axis. The angle of the other pole, angle of departure of other pole is plus 90. So, take a line at the plus 90. 90 matlab again perpendicular. Matlab take it vertical. Okay. And this angle will be plus 90. Okay. So, there will be other branch. There will be other branch. Traveling vertically upwards. ट्रैवलिंग वर्टिकली अपवर्ड्स. ठीक है. नो 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 कविता, फोर ब्रांचेस आर नॉट गोइंग टू बीट एट द ब्रेक अवे पॉइंट. नॉट दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन हियर बिकॉज देर इज अनदर ब्रेक अवे पॉइंट. आई हैव शोन यू, सी आई हैव शोन यू माइनस टू प्लस माइनस जे 2.4 आर ऑल्सो वैलिड कॉम्प्लेक्स ब्रेक अवे पॉइंट. ओके, सो लेट अस स्केच दिस ब्रेक अवे पॉइंट. माइनस टू प्लस जे 2.4 अप्रोक्सीमेटली हेयर, दिस इज अ ब्रेक अवे पॉइंट. ओके, and minus 2 minus j 2.4 is somewhere approximately here, and that means what. Okay, that basically means that two branches, now listen here, this breakaway was incomplete. Okay, here I have made the branches intersect, but where the branches are going to go? Branches are going to go after the breakaway, after meeting the branches on the real axis, they go towards the complex plane. So what is going to happen? Because there is another complex breakaway point, this goes vertically upwards so that you make the intersection happen. So this goes vertically upwards. Just a second. And this one goes, and this one is going to go vertically downwards. One branch travels vertically downwards. It is another breakaway point. This is vertically upwards. Here also, this branch is traveling upwards, and the branch starting from the complex pole is traveling minus 90 degree downwards. Minus 90 degree downwards. And they intersect at this breakaway point. Okay. So I have shown you the complex breakaway point. Okay. Complex breakaway point. Yeah, it no, if the asymptote is other than 2, means what asymptote? Do you want to specify the centroid, Vashishta? Please, can you make that clear? Okay, so now, listen everyone, let me complete the plot first. Yeah. This is all the set of the breakaway points. This is all the set of the breakaway points. Okay, 3 breakaway points, matlab 3 intersections, all are valid here. 3 breakaway matlab 3 intersections. So I have shown you 3 intersection. I have shown you the 3 intersection. Okay. This is one. Okay. This is what? This is the normal breakaway point as I have explained you. And yesterday I have also explained you break in. Okay. This is a breakaway point. What is this? This is, dear students, complex breakaway. This is the concept of complex breakaway point. So what do you understand by complex breakaway? When the branches... This is also complex breakaway. When the branches intersect in the complex plane and travel back in the complex plane. Now, because there is no more breakaway point, I yesterday kya funda bola tha? I have told you 3 funda yesterday. Start, intersect, terminate. For sketching, start the branches, make them intersect, starting from the poles, intersection at the breakaway point, and terminate. Terminate either at the open loop zeros or at infinity. Okay, there are no open loop zeros, so terminate towards infinity. And for infinity, you have sketched the... You have sketched what? You have sketched the asymptotes. So now I am going to take the branches towards infinity, matlab towards asymptote. So see dear guys, yes. From here, one of the branch is going to travel towards this asymptote, and other one is going to travel towards this asymptote, and they are going to conclude. Okay. Similarly, symmetrically downwards, root locus is always symmetric with respect to the real axis. This will be k tending to infinity towards the asymptote, k tending to infinity, and towards the asymptote, k tending to infinity. Starting is at k equal to 0. Starting matlab at the poles, I will specify k equal to 0. Here also this is a pole, so k is equal to 0. Here also this is a pole, so k is equal to 0. And that is the complete root locus for this given GSHS. Okay. Yes, complex breakaway, Shiv Prasad, we calculated minus 2 plus minus j 2.4. Yes, this is the complete breakaway of the given, this is the complete root locus plot of the given system. This is also a complex breakaway. ठीक है, तो देर आर टू कॉम्प्लेक्स ब्रेकअवे पॉइंट्स एंड माइंड द फैक्ट दैट यस कॉम्प्लेक्स ब्रेकअवे पॉइंट कैन ऑल्सो एग्जिस्ट, मे और मे नॉट बी, बट इट मे एग्जिस्ट, इट मे एग्जिस्ट एंड दैट इज द फाइनल रूट लोकस. ठीक है, दिस इज नॉर्मली द ब्रेकअवे पॉइंट, इज नो कंफ्यूजन विद दैट, दैट इज द नॉर्मल ब्रेकअवे पॉइंट एज वी हैव बीन सीइंग यस्टरडे. दिस इज वन इंटरसेक्शन, दिस इज अनदर इंटरसेक्शन. ओके, रादर आई विल जस्ट डू वन सिंपल थिंग फॉर यू. I'll highlight the intersections separately. I'll highlight the intersections separately. This is one intersection. This is one intersection breakaway. And this is another intersection that is breakaway. Okay. And now what I was telling in the beginning that, anyways, when you start sketching the root locus, what you do? Okay. You start sketching the poles and zeros. Okay. Right, clear, start sketching the poles and zeros, and when you start sketching the poles and zeros there itself, quickly you can calculate by tan inverse height upon base, and that is equal to the angle of departure calculation will come. Okay. Yeah, Kavita, I feel the same today, and really sorry for you guys. Yeah, today I don't know for whatsoever reason, I'm not able to respond well. I'm little disturbed and the health is not good. But, it keeps on happening. But, you guys have been enjoying my control system classes from past 2 weeks. Okay. And no problem. Yes, tomorrow we do have the very important MCQ class coming up. So, there anyways, I'm going to take more questions. MCQ questions on breakaway and break-in points. I'm going to take there. Need not worry about that. I'm going to take the questions there. Right. So is that clear to everyone? Yes, guys, today. So tomorrow, as I've told you, today I'll just stop with this class. Okay. But tomorrow, as I have promised you, tomorrow, that is the class of root locus 3. I hope you have still enjoyed this class. And if you have enjoyed, just show your love to the Grade Up Gate YouTube channel. Hit the like button if you have not still liked the session. Yes, everyone, just show your love. Hit the like button to your favorite Grade Up Gate YouTube channel. Okay, so Root Locus 3 class tomorrow. Okay, and that is all about the important MCQ and numerical answer type questions. Okay, how to approach them quickly. Quick methods, and even in that class, again angle of departure phi d and phi a, angle of departure and angle of arrival, it is going to be repeated tomorrow itself. So tomorrow is more important. That is the MCQ and NET question practice class where we talk about angle of departures and angle of arrivals. Okay. Okay, fine. So this question, we have cleared the idea of complex breakaway also. I took this question for two reasons. One, to make you realize that yes, complex breakaway can exist. And second one, angle of departure and angle of arrival. Okay, angle of arrival, we'll see. Angle of departure at least seen, but same method for angle of arrival. Okay, same method for the angle of arrival will come. The only difference is angle of arrival formula will become 180 minus phi z minus phi p. Phi z minus phi p. Okay. Yes, Ramu, that's good if you are able to know some new points, and that is how you can improve your rank. This time you should be having a very good rank, at least under 50 or under 20. Target that. Yes. Chaliye, dear students, let me sign off right now. Wish you all the best for your studies. Keep studying hard. Stay safe. Like the YouTube session. And I'll see you tomorrow at the same time, 8 p.m. on your favorite Grade Up Gate YouTube channel. Bye-bye. Take care and study hard at home and stay safe at home. Bye bye and do take care of yourself.